In 1934, Church of the Brethren Annual Conference passed a statement that says all war is sin. And yet, as I said earlier this week, a statement against war does not make a person or an organization peacemakers. It doesn't. Truth is, you could agree with a statement and yet not have peace in your heart. Why? Well, because from a biblical understanding, peace is much more than putting down our rocks and our swords. To be a peacemaker, a person must first have a change of heart. So let's talk about that today on this final installment of Peace, studying the Christian attribute of peace or being a peacemaker. My name's Pastor Greg, and this is Transforming the World. Question number 15 asks this: am I cooperating with God to make myself a person of peace? When I become a person of peace, we have to change our view, especially our view of those who think differently and act differently than us. I mean, we're not peacemakers when our protests cause strife or division. I mean, we protest against war and it causes strife and division. How's that being a peacemaker? Because you're adding conflict, you're putting tension in the room. You're truly not being a peacemaker. We become peacemakers according to scriptures when we love even those who are not peacemakers. Let me say that again. To be a true Christian peacemaker means that we love those who are not peacemakers. And instead of speaking out against them in anger or disgust and hate, we learn to love them. And we come alongside that person. I mean, that's the art of being a peacemaker, right? It's not putting an end to war, but it is righting a broken relationship between ourselves and somebody else and that person and God. Yet sometimes it seems to me that we Christians have taken too lightly the Lord's command to love one another. This is the one single thing that separates a Christian from the rest of the world. That command to love one another is the one single thing that separates a Christian from the rest of the world. Oh, I know. You might come along and you say, hold on a second. Wait, hold your horses. What about the times that the church feeds the hungry or clothes the naked or cares for the sick or works for peace or gives to charities or cares for the environment? Are these not examples of Christians actually being in the world? Well, the problem is even non-Christians do those things. Even non-Christians pursue peace. Even non-Christians feed the hungry. Even non-Christians clothe the naked. So you can't come along and say, these are examples of our Christianity, because they're not any different, because a non-Christian can do those things. So it's not those actions that separate us from the world. It's not those actions that identify us as Christians. According to Jesus Christ, it is our love for one another that truly demonstrates that we are his disciples. The one single thing that stands a believer apart from the world is the humble, loving way a Christian treats those who hurt him, those who are against him, those who have wronged him, and those who are his enemies. A believer is easily identified by a peaceful, forgiving spirit that keeps no record of wrongs, that makes allowances for other people's mistakes, that understands people will have a bad day from time to time. Romans 12:17 says, Do all that you can to live in peace with everyone. And I suspect that what was going through Paul's mind at that moment when he said, do everything that you can to live at peace with everyone, I suspect what was going through Paul's mind at that moment was as he stood there watching a young man by the name of Stephen being stoned to death. As Paul watched that Christian being stoned to death, he no doubt heard Stephen say these words, Lord, do not hold this sin against them. Acts 7:60. And it was that attitude of love in the midst of a very trying, difficult situation that made Christianity stand out from the rest of the world. Stephen was not identified as a Christian because he helped with the distribution of food, not in Paul's eyes. But I'm sure in Paul's eyes that it was this unrestrained love for those who persecuted him that Paul was thinking back to when he says, do all that you can to live at peace with everyone. From a denomination that promotes peace, I have heard some pretty harsh words directed toward those who don't share those same values. There have been some mighty mean words directed toward Christians in the military by my denomination. And from my perspective, those individuals are not peacemakers. They claim to be, but they're not. They are creating division and strife and spewing hate and anger. They are tearing down relationships, all because somebody feels a little bit differently than they do. To truly be a peacemaker, my friend, we need to pray for those who don't share our same values. Pray for them. Seek the best for them. Ask the Lord to bless them. Ask the Lord to keep them. Ask the Lord to watch over them. Not criticize that person because their values and beliefs are different than yours. You simply cannot be an instrument of peace if there is hatred in your heart. You cannot. I'll say that again. You cannot be an instrument of peace if there is hatred in your heart. Protests do not make you a peacemaker because you can still have hatred in your heart while you protest. Passing statements does not make you a peacemaker because even though you agree to the statement, you hate those who don't. No, my friend, to truly be a peacemaker is to have a heart filled with love and humility and a genuine concern and care for even those who persecute you. So next week we're going to take a look at the characteristic of wisdom. I hope you can join us then. This week we've been looking at peace. And I really appreciate you spending the time with me today. I hope you have a blessed weekend, and I'll talk to you again on Monday. Bye-bye.